At the beginning, your data model only shows your tables and the relationships between them, and any additional steps you've added to prepare or transform your data. Right now, your model doesn't contain any data. To actually import the data and format it correctly, you need to build the ElasticCube model. When you finish designing your data model, click the Build button. You now see several options here. By default, you see Replace All and Changes Only. If you've customized the individual tables, a third option will appear, By Table. The first option you see here is Replace All. What this does is it builds the ElasticCube from scratch. This is the option you choose if it's the first time you're building your model. Keep in mind that the size of your data and the connection speed between your data sources can impact the amount of time it takes to complete the build. The second option, Changes Only, takes into account any changes to your ElasticCube model that were done since your last build. For example, new removed tables and changes to a custom table or column. This type of build is useful if you have large amounts of data but want to reduce the amount of time it takes to complete a build. The third option for building an ElasticCube model is by table. When you've customized the table's build behavior, an icon is displayed that indicates the table's build behavior, for example, append. In this example, tables where the build behavior hasn't been defined use the global setting, replace all, whereas tables that have been defined are built according to the behavior defined for that table. The benefit here again is to reduce the amount of time it takes to complete a build. Another option you have below here is the sample data switch. If you're doing any type of testing, you can toggle the sample data switch and define the number of rows you want to import for each table. This is useful to limit how much data is pulled, so you can do stuff such as test your connections to a data source without having to run a full build. You can run additional builds whenever you need to refresh the data in the ElasticCube. For more information about ElasticCube builds, see our online documentation.